Hello and welcome to this Manufacturing Systems Technology Module 35. In the last module, we have been discussing about the fixed sequential format. And let me just get back to this particular statement here. So if you see in this fixed sequential format, you can see that there are many numbers, again, which are, you know, representing different things. So I think we had learned that these are the different blocks. And we had also learned that these are the different commands in picture. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 commands. So also there are positive and negative signs, you know, in the different commands. So probably there's an indication of something related to the nomenclature associated with directions, if you may remember, that we had talked about last time. So in fact, this fixed sequential format is about a drilling process. And let's understand what this format says so that the controller does something in a very organized manner so that you can do the machine drilling. So obviously, if you look at this figure here, right about here, this is the workpiece that is being drilled. And the tool is positioned at some place, probably which can be called as the tool origin, okay? And there is a path of the tool which would get executed from this particular origin O to the machining center, which is actually the point where the drilling starts. Let's call this point S, okay? So this is the start of the drilling operation. So from O to S, there is a sort of a rapid transit of the tool, because this is really the time wasting part of the whole machining phase. Obviously, you cannot position the O to S, because then it will mean that the drill may start fouling with the workpiece while placing the workpiece, and that's something that you want to avoid. So obviously the tool has to be at a certain distance away from the workpiece when the workpiece has been positioned and clamped in the particular jig where it has to be held and started with the machining operation or the drilling operation. Okay, so the O and S are different, the origin and the start point are different, and so obviously there has to be some kind of a rapid positioning tool, which I will actually talk about a little later. But rapid positioning means at the earliest possible time, because it's a member here, the drilling tool is, the tip of the drilling is present actually here. So particularly here, so it only means that because it's not touching the workpiece, you can rapidly move the drill in this particular area to come to S, okay, wasting as less time as possible. So probably this 00 here would relate to some kind of information, some information regarding this rapid motion. You can see the numbers in block 1, block 2 and block 3 as 0050, 0060 and 0070. So obviously, probably this would mean that it is an index number. Okay, we already identified that the machine would read based on 1 to 10 or 1 to 3 in this particular case. So it will read first block 1, this first, then block 2, then block 3. So therefore, you know, you can easily assume that the machine is reading first line here and reporting it as 0050. Obviously, the next number it is going to read is going to be a higher order number. So here the higher order number that it finds is 0060, so after 50-60 and then after 60-70. So there is a spacing of 10 in between. It can vary between different programming languages, and the spacing is typically given because if you want to, let's say, modify the program at some point of time later and insert some kind of a statement or a line within these two index numbers, you already have a provision of 9 numbers in between, or 9 number statements in between, which can come. So 50 can be preceded, succeeded by 51, 52, 53, so on up to 60. So these 10 numbers have been left blank intentionally, because you allow the flexibility of the program to be changed later on, okay, and that's how the index number has been based. So this is about index number. So obviously, the first item here, which appears to be having or holding a plus sign, should maybe mean something related to the motion along a certain axis, and the value that is appended to it may also mean something which is related to the corresponding value where the tool has to probably traverse. Okay. So in this particular case, for example, you can see that the first value mentions plus 0025400, okay, and plus 0012500. So what is meaning here is that probably this is the x coordinate of motion. Okay, so wherever the tool was placed, if we consider that to be the origin 0 and 0, so from 0, 0, the tool has to move exactly at 25.4 millimeters. That's how the nomenclature has been laid here, 25.4 millimeters along the positive x direction, okay, and 12.5 millimeters along the positive y direction. There is no movement as of now in the z direction. So we keep this sort of fixed. We can assume that this block is somewhat like this, and we can also further assume that, you know, the xy is in the same plane as the s. So we are not assuming that the xy is out of the block or something. It is in the same plane as s in this particular case. Okay, so therefore you can say that there is a motion which allows this point O, the tool at point O, to go exactly to 24.5 and 12.5 millimeters. Okay, it's a very fantastic way of writing. So basically you have written 25.4 millimeters as the number plus 0025400, and which means that you are defining this dot in a manner by actually going four places to the left of the dot and three places to the right of the dot. Okay, so therefore the capability that the controller may have is to read between 9999.999 to 0000.000. So that's the range at which the controller would be able to read in terms of millimeters. Okay, so that's the reason why this concept of 25.4 being laid out as 0025400. Okay, so you are actually enabling the controller here, or the programmer here, based on the capacity of the controller, of course, to give a range of values corresponding to the x value here, starting from 9999.99 to 0000.00. Okay, and some value which is probably the actual value here as recorded in this particular number is 0025.400, and similarly on the y axis as 12.5 millimeters or 0012500. Okay, so these are all on the positive x and the y direction. Obviously positive x and y direction would mean that if you consider the depth starting from this plane onwards here to be the z axis, then the positive z direction obviously is in the direction projected away from the workpiece plane. Okay, so I can consider this to be the plane of the workpiece, as I had mentioned before. So this block is positioned somewhat like this. Okay, let me just redraw a little bit. So the block is positioned somewhat like this. And similarly, you have the block positioned like that. So this is the surface along which the tool is placed somewhere away from the block, and the tool is being dragged along exactly to move 25.4 mm towards the positive x direction, which is this direction, okay, and this direction 25.4 mm and 12.4 towards the positive y direction. Okay, so this is how you are placing the xyz coordinate axes. This is a right-handed orthogonal axis. Okay, you have to make sure that you are having a right-handed orthogonal coordinate system. So you have the x motion along the positive x direction here, the positive y direction here, and the positive direction z direction away from the face of the workpiece. Okay, so in this manner you are bringing the tool from the point O right about here at least 25.4 mm in the x direction and 12.5 mm in the y direction, so that you can hit upon the point S in this particular plane. Okay, so I hope I'm clear here actually. And then you have finished this, so the z direction right now is 0. So we assume that the tool is almost at the workpiece tool interface. Okay, and then we are suggesting, so basically you know, there may be a possibility that you may allow a little bit of allowance in the z direction earlier, but in this particular case we did not, because of the because of the simplicity in the programming that would happen because of allowing it to just about the tip. So in this case it is a situation where there is a block and the drill tip has just about come close to this. Probably it was placed somewhere here, from which the drilling position is somewhere here. So the drill tip has come to this position, okay, and then it is allowed to rotate, okay, and you can see the next block, that is block number 60 here, which talks about this. So here the one thing which is important is that you cannot rapid position anymore, because obviously now the cutting motion is going to start. So there has to be a feed rate with which the drill would be governing the motion inside the block, okay. So there has to be some kind of a linear feed rate. So probably the 01 right about here means something to do with linear positioning, okay. And linear positioning is different than rapid positioning. I will show you exactly what is the difference in little bit later slides, but linear positioning would be at a control rate of positioning at a certain axis, and then obviously you are starting from the same position, 25.4 mm and 12.5 mm with the linear positioning, and before starting you have switched on the drill machine so that it starts rotating. You have switched on the drill machine and have started to giving it a feed, you know, and this feed is given in 500 millimeters per minute, okay. So it's a down feed, it's a linear feed in terms of 500 millimeters per minute in the negative z direction. So therefore you're also at the same time giving a different index value to this z coordinate here, which mind you was 0000.000 earlier, which was at the surface of the block, but now you are giving a negative sign, meaning the tool is proceeding towards the workpiece, and it is proceeding so around 10 units, that means around 10 mm within this particular drilled hole. So typically whenever you drill a hole and it's a through hole, you have to ensure that the drill tip goes to the other side of the block. In this particular case the block is about 9 mm thick, so you must be putting something like wood or something which is a, you know, a bottom which is amenable to this drilling process, and let the drill traverse all the way from the zero z equal to 0 point at the surface all the way to about 10 mm so that it clears off the hole and makes it a through hole. Okay, so once this negative 10 mm at the rate of 500 mm per minute has been achieved with the rotating drill, obviously you have switched on the drill. You need also a coolant to do that, so you have started the coolant on by saying 08. 08 is an option probably, or a number which indicates that the coolant should be started. So coolant start, I will say, okay. And then the question is that the drill is now not left in that position rotating, it has to be taken back to the top position. So therefore now, because you are using an absolute positioning system, you have gone z minus 10 and you have to come back to z 0, okay. So therefore in the third step, or the block 70, you are seeing that the positions x and y are not changing. Again it is going in a linear manner, so linearly positioning itself, but it is starting from minus 10 right about here, and the next portion, once it has gone to minus 10, it has no job to do anymore, so it comes back to the zero position. That means from here it comes back to the surface here, okay, and still the feed rate has been continuing, because obviously the problem here is that you cannot repeat any command, okay, and so the 500 has to be mentioned. So this is done at the same 500 rate, but now maybe you did not use the coolant because already the drilling has completed and it is just a extraction process. So therefore 09 here means that the coolant has been switched off, okay. So this whole modality explains that how a fixed sequential format can be formulated. So in the next module we will like to do the tab sequential format as well in a similar manner. Thank you.